Jake, fuck
you, oh my fucking god. I can't believe this guy.
That's fucking stupid. He's got his...
Bro, you see this? You see this? That's real audio quality. You come in here with your... Oh, $500 headphones. Oh, $500.
Take them off right now.
Shut up, bro. Oh my god. I bet you can't even hear a word that I'm saying right now, bro. Oh my god, bro. Get his ass. Get his ass right now. I'm tired of it. I want him gone.
5 seconds.
I want him gone.
Right now.
Shoot. Shoot. Do it. Do it. Do it, pussy. Do it. Do it. Yeah. 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 Winning. Everyone, I got the car back.
Yeah.
Yes,
congratulations.
Dude. Also, I prayed really hard and they came back to life. That's how that works.
Yeah, no, it's true.
Because canonically, God again. Is real on the Good Enough Podcast.
What do you mean?
That is
on
true.
The Good Enough Podcast. All
right. This I'm just saying with podcast, I'm right, just saying within our within our lore of the show. It's like, you know how Smiling Friends, it's like the Christian God is the correct God.
Yeah.
That's well, that's okay, for but, us.
But yeah. Isn't that just like how it is? Like... Welcome to the show, everyone. Play the music now.
We're going to get really philosophical and debate moral topics like Christianity,
like the death sentence.
Luke's secret YouTube channel where he debunks Christianity.
It's called
you guys know Luke has the highest upvoted post on r/atheism.
On r/boobies.
I
love boobs. I love boobs, you guys. I love boobs.
you go and check on r. Yeah. It's like top all time post.
Yeah,
it's
so
like top all time post on r/atheism. It's like me, and I just say, guys, this God guy, don't know. I just don't know.
I don't know about all this.
I imagine you just like post yourself like blank faced and you just post it on r/atheist and becomes the top rated thing. Like,
I'm gonna check.
No, what comment, do you guys, what, no description.
I want to see what the top rated.
Someone. All right. Wait. Hold on. Someone take a screenshot of this and of my face and put on
atheist. Wait. There you go. All right. Yeah. Wait till the camera gets focused.
Okay.
This is why we can never have good things. Jackson actually brings a topic of conversation. We shut him down. I was like,
hold on,
God.
Wait. I'm looking at. I'll get back to the car, but I want. I'm checking the top. What the fuck? The top post in r/atheism. The satan. What the fuck? The Satanic Temple just announced a satanic ritual abortion, placing the medical procedure under the protections of the Religious Freedom Restoration Act.
Wait. So they're woke?
I get.
Is that what that
means? You're telling me these guys are woke? I'm done.
r/atheism has
Satanists
gone too
are
far.
Supporting abortions or something. I don't know. Whatever.
Abortions are cool.
But yeah, I got the car.
Jackson got a car.
So I was working like a, I had a full day of
Jackson's
work yesterday.
Speaking of hating God, Jackson has a new vehicle.
Yeah. So I for those of you who don't know, I fucked my car up on a rock in Joshua Tree, and it's been in the mechanic for months.
Yeah.
And so last night I was working all day, and I come home, I'm talking with my dad. I'm like, any updates from the mechanic? He's like, no. I'm like, all right, great. And then later he was like, hey, we need more milk. Can you get it from the fridge in the garage? I was like, okay, bet. Open the garage. And the key is in there, but I was so focused on getting the milk that I walk right past it, open up the fridge, and got the milk. And I go back inside, and I'm like, yo, here's the milk. And he's like, are you fucking stupid? And I was like, no, you asked for milk. Like, I don't know what you're talking about. He's like, how tired are you? I'm like, what are you talking about? I was like, what is this? I'm like, here's the fucking milk. He's like, go put the milk back. And I was like, okay. So I go back into the garage, I put the milk back, and I come back inside. I'm like, and he's like, what are you doing? And I'm like, you said to put the milk back. I don't know what you want from me. And then he's like, dude, your fucking car's in the garage. So it's back. A couple more repairs still need to happen, but it's drivable.
Yay.
So we're back in business, baby. The key is back in action.
This is nice. Well,
this is
does that mean you have to work three?
Leave a comment if you guys like my like me. If you guys like me, leave a comment.
Jackson, go get the milk in the garage.
does that mean you have to work your three jobs now? Or
yes,
so you still have to pay for it. So you still have to pay for it, but your car is returned.
Yes. So your dad was like the UPS driver. He wanted to make a big scene about it, but he didn't even pay for it. He's just like, yeah, here it is.
He's like, yeah, this is it. Now sign here.
Shout out to Jackson's dad. Signed HBO consultant, Regan Burns. Get in that bag, I hope.
Wait, your dad's a HBO consultant?
Well, he's on the commercial.
Oh, for Max.
He's in that Max commercial.
All right, HBO wait. Max should we bring to the public the famous comment that we got?
Oh yeah.
Can't believe we haven't said this on the podcast. I can't believe we haven't
forgot about that.
Can't believe we haven't said this on the podcast.
Well, we haven't seen each other Luke, in like a fucking.
All right, so on YouTube, someone did a re-upload of the commercial that Jackson's dad was in. And for context, the plot of the commercial is that Jackson's dad is like, we're spending too much money on streaming services, so here's what we gotta do. Grandma, I'm sorry, but we're kicking you out of the house. And it's like, you're too, like...
Get fucked, Grandma!
And they make a joke, they're like, I'm sorry, like, for the most part, like, I have nothing wrong with you, like, I have nothing against you or whatever. And then the mom is like... And then the mom is like, well, how about we just start using Max? And it's like... Because they have everything we already watch, and we can just use that. Yeah. And then it's like a big joke. It's like, ha ha ha, they could just use Max instead of kicking their grandma out of the house, right? Joan Sansa on YouTube leaves a comment on this re-upload of this commercial. It says, beautiful. I'm sorry, but I do not find this commercial amusing. It is on so frequently, it has become annoying. It also... makes the husband look like a real self-centered ass. I want to slap him. If he were my husband, we would be having a very serious argument. The commercial is insulting.
Just imagine having him as your dad.
The commercial is insulting to seniors and appears to promote disrespect and elder abuse. Isn't there enough disrespect and abuse at every turn in the real world? Next, you'll have grandma pull out a gun and shoot the sob. Shame on you. Which I have to ask, you know this isn't real, right? Like, this is not, like, Regan didn't actually...
People forget that, dude.
No, I told you guys this. Old people that watch YouTube and they, like, watch stuff like... They think everything they see is real. And this is not ageist. Like, you read these comments and you cannot, like, read them any other way other than the fact that they think what is happening in this commercial is real.
That's facts. This burrito is spicy as fuck, and I'm sweating, so I'm gonna go get water while you guys
see this conversation. Low key, during that,
could you hear us still?
Yes. Okay. I'm back.
Jake, you were like,
what happened?
You were like, oh my god, guys, I was worried that my internet was going out and I was about to and then you froze for 30 seconds. That shit was awesome.
It froze on the other end. I guess we're using
shit
Luke's
was
fucking.
Awesome.
That what just happened?
Jake fucking froze for 30 seconds. Yeah. Oh,
man, what a fucking loser.
The Wi-Fi box is right next to me. Like, if I, like, I could poke it and I'm scared. Like, god, last thing I need is my
phone. Oh, man, that was funny. That was funny. So, guys, you got any crazy stories to tell the pod? We haven't had many story episodes in a while. So,
I have one more.
Stories? Whoa.
So,
story?
I had work. This is like a week ago. I had my first job in the morning and afternoon, and then my last job at night. I had a 2-hour break between the two of them. And luckily for me, both the jobs are right near where my local record store is.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh, this is perfect. I'll just go to the record store for a bit, hang out there, scroll through, maybe find something cool. And so I'm going through it. I found some cool stuff. I had picked out in my hand, I had Mirror to Mirror, the Twin Fantasy Mirror to Mirror version. And then I found some random...
very cool.
What is it? Silvermount Zion record that I hadn't seen before. I was like, oh, this could be cool. And I was going to check out... But then I was like, oh my god, I forgot there's an experimental, like, slash noise section here. Maybe I'll just try to find something that looks cool and see what it sounds like. So I'm scrolling through, I'm looking for, like, album covers that pop out to me. And I find this one album, and I'm like, oh my god, this cover looks so cool. But there's a problem. There's no album title or artist name or any information on the cover or in the sleeve or on the actual record. It just has a cover, and that's it.
George by Costanza.
Which they did have. But I It was the day that I sent you that photo, Jake.
Yeah, that's why I was like, no way the end point of the story is George.
That'd be so funny. No, but I take it to the front. I'm like, hey, do you guys have any information about this? And they're like, okay, we'll look it up. So like, there was like etch. You know how some records have like etchings on like the inside that tell you what the number is and stuff. So they looked it up and like, oh my god, we can't find anything for this. We have no idea what this is. And I put away the other two records. I was like, fuck it, I'm just gonna get this one. I'm so curious. I want to hear what this sounds like. So I bring it home and I kind of forget about it for a few days because I've been super busy. I didn't have time to listen to it.
Mm-hmm.
But this morning I'm like, today's the day I listen to this record. Let me get it just so you can see what I'm talking about.
What if it's like the Beatles White Album and it's just like,
you just didn't. So this is the cover right here.
That's cool.
This is like paper. And like this is like regular like sleeve material, but this is paper. So I was like, this is so interesting. On the back it's just plain white, but on here written in marker, it just says FGW 2016. This is not like part of the packaging. Someone wrote this on the record. And then the actual, let me get the disc too so you can see.
I'm so intrigued by this.
The actual disc has this little symbol on it, and then just playing on the back.
Yeah.
Dude, I put it on this morning, and it starts with some guy talking in German, just talking. And I'm like, what the fuck? What am I listening to? And then finally I hear him say, like, 2 minutes in, I hear him say, like, he's speaking German, English. And then they switch to English, and it's just an interview. The whole record is just an interview with I think it's the painter of these, like, pieces. I'm like, dude, this is the most disappointed I've been in my whole life. I spent $20 on this. It was just an interview with some German artist. Why would you ever press that onto vinyl? This is all, unless it was, like, some ancient
That's an
pressing.
Interview?
It's just two guys talking. I didn't listen to the whole thing. I just kind of skipped through, but it's just two guys talking.
Bro bought a $20 podcast.
The first five minutes is just this guy trying, because the interviewee is only speaks English, and the other guy is German and kind of speaks English, and the whole first 5 minutes is this guy trying to explain to the German guy of how to share his screen through the internet. I'm like, this is the worst thing I've ever done, like, purchased in my life. I could have gotten Twin Fantasy.
It's not.
I could have gotten Silver Mount Zion. They had a bunch of cool Criterion DVDs here.
Like Three.
Not a single note is played on this disc.
This is how Zoom works. Make sure you share your screen.
It makes sense if this was like the 1930s and this is the only way to get interviews out. But this is clearly a newer pressing. Like, this is a very new and good condition pressing. Why would you do this? And then put it in the experimental / noise section.
And it's not
labeled?
This
is neither of those things. And it's not labeled.
All I'm hearing is a bunch of noise, if you catch my drift, buddy.
Dude, listen, that's what I'm saying. A whole bunch of fucking yapping. I was so upset. This could have been such a cool moment.
If it was a Phil Elverum interview, you would have been hyped.
If I was stupid rich, I would start a podcast, and every episode was only distributed on vinyl.
That'd be fucking sick. Someone take that 45 idea. Right
Can
now.
Someone press the first episode of Good Enough onto record? No, we got to which episode should we press the record?
Well, if we're serious, I'd say like the best ofs or like the fucking the award
like
shows,
we should make so it a like box a, set. We should make it a box
yeah.
set with like multiple episodes.
So it's
episodes.
Like a year in review.
I feel like the first episode, though, is a good... I don't know. That's charming to do it, you know? Cute. It's like the intro.
Yeah, but also we have the shitty Discord audio for both you and me, Jackson.
That's true.
Yeah, I sound fine. Y'all suck.
Yeah.
No. What are you going to do?
I guess we should do
what
National
do you, mean, you and me? I have the same mic I'm using now. It was the same audio quality.
Yeah, Luke had a headset.
It was still Discord quality. Like, we still, like, cut out and stuff.
Bro had a headset. Bro had a mic the size of his pinky. He's like, no, it sounds fine.
It was like right here.
Jackson sounds bad too.
Yes. Yeah.
Big hammer, baby. Let's talk about it.
James
we got
Blake,
some shit
guys,
to talk about.
What's up?
James Blake.
We know you're
is
watching,
back,
James. What's
better
up?
Better than ever. Back in black. You know the vibe. James Blake is back with
friend of the
track,
show, James Blake.
Friend of the show, James Blake, with a track, album, tour. He's got the whole shebang here.
He announced a tour?
We're thinking of Big Hammer. Yeah.
Wait, what the hell? I didn't see that.
Yeah, It fuck me, right? He's going to New York the exact same day everything is. So whoops, I guess. Guess we're not going to see that.
That's tough.
All right, well, let me say this. Let me say this. Before we get into his music, I recently looked more into the person that that James writes all his love songs about that he's currently in a relationship with. How? She's so annoying.
Who is it?
Whoa! Oh,
no, just his
fuck. You pull this out.
His partner.
God, that guy. Wait!
Time out. James Blake is straight.
Yeah. What?
I don't know. I just thought.
I mean, who knows? I mean,
he just emanated such bottom energy. Jackson thought he was gay.
I thought he was gay.
He's dating Jamila Jamil.
Jackson sounded like, damn it. All my fantasies are ruined.
No! How am I ever going to make it in this industry?
His sweet, sultry British voice.
No.
What do you think about Big Hammer Jake?
Well, no, I want to hear Luke justify why he thinks someone's girlfriend's a bitch.
I didn't say that.
She said it. I heard it.
I did not say that. I always
editor,
said,
run it back real quick.
He said it off podcast.
Shorts editor, run it back real quick.
That's me. He's dating Jamila Jamil, and I just saw something on Twitter the other day. Something she said, and it was just annoying. And someone,
what'd she say?
I don't remember. It was just annoying. That's all. That's all I had to say about
James
that.
Blake, Luke Stone has something to say about your girlfriend. What are you going to do about it, pal?
I just personally just was annoyed.
James Blake girlfriend, annoying. Anyway.
Anyway, yeah, it's funny, welcome dude. Back.
Oh, man.
Guys, James Blake, Big Hammer. So.
Oh, I remember what she said. I remember now. We're back, guys. We're so back.
We're so fucking back.
What she said was, she essentially was like, talking about the Oscars, and the Oscars are like considering removing their like gendered categories, so like best female or best male, anything that regards sex and gender, right? And so, Jamila Jamil was like, hey, how about we remove neither, and instead we introduce a best non-binary actor, or best non-binary actor or actress or whatever.
And that is like one person.
Yeah, that's the point. It's like, there will be like three people in that category when you could just remove it, and I just found that annoying, and that was all. Anyway, what's up,
yeah,
guys?
Big fuck Hammer. Her, dude. Fuck her.
Big Hammer, welcome back.
I think I can confidently say we've always been talking about the Mount Rushmore penis music. This is number four. This is number four.
Dude, it totally is number four penis music.
It does.
Bro released penis music as the lead single to his new album.
It is.
Bro, what?
I mean,
it's penis music.
It is penis music.
Penis music.
Hold on. Totally I'm gonna go listen to it right now, and
I'm listening. It's just penis music.
Oh my god, totally dude, guys, we'll get to the cover arts in a second, but look at his Spotify header. Go to Spotify on like your computer or something. Look at the header. That goes fucking crazy. That is insane.
That goes nuts.
Is it the scanned picture of him?
No.
All right. Well, I'm not on my laptop.
It's like the human condition, like type shit. It's like people walking up a mountain. Very cool.
But the song is like.
You know what? Not just to get my opinion out there. Not my favorite James Blake song, but I don't think it's bad by any means.
I agree. I think it is a perfectly acceptable James Blake kind of. I mean, it's more trap than anything. I think I'm more excited because this is the type of James Blake stuff that I enjoy, like that weirder sound. Maybe not really trap per se. But I just really enjoy when James experiments a little bit, like he did on his like first few records. And I feel like that this is kind of a return to that. Also, easily, bar none, best like promotional art of his entire career, probably. Like, literally. Like, Jake, you can have more to say about that, but yeah.
I don't know if I'd go that far. I think he's had other promotional that was much better, but still very good. But the reason, not only is Big Hammer kind of, what's the word, controversial because of the sound reception. You guys seem to not be digging it as much as I am. Even though I call the penis music, I think it's fucking awesome. I think it sounds so cool. We also have a little scuffle of, a little fisticuffs, if you will, of the album cover situation. So, James Blake announced yesterday that he's putting out he just said Big Hammer coming tomorrow, whatever. And it's this crazy, I don't know how much work you want to do, Jackson, but if you want to throw it up, like this weird Slipknot, like, electronic wires coming out of it.
So fucking
head.
Cool.
Like,
so
it
badass.
It looks so cool.
And I wonder how they made that.
I know. And then the song came out, and for you guys on Spotify, it's just the it's whatever. And then I was like, oh, hard ball drop that he didn't use the Big Hammer cover as the album cover. And you're like, what are you talking about? I'm like, and I showed the album cover on stream on Apple because it shows you like the album cover.
Yeah.
And it's the people walking up the hill.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Luke pulled some shit out of his ass that frankly upset me.
I said
know.
That I
something
I
to the
up.
Extent of, hang on, let me get the real wording down. I want to make sure that I don't misquote the gentleman, even though he's sitting right in front of me. He said, "That's insane. I honestly like that more." TBH.
Okay.
Here's the thing though, Jacob, because you know what? I agree with you. However, comma, you put up a poll on our Patreon server asking people what they think, and everyone seems to agree with Luke that the other cover is better.
Oh, shit.
In what
blur,
universe?
If we use my recording, blur that out, Jackson. I accidentally showed part of my screen.
A photo of my cock. A photo of my cock, sorry. Sorry, guys. Yeah, I put a poll on Patreon. I didn't even allude to which one I liked. I was just like, subtle a GEP like scuffle. Which is better? A Big Hammer and something about robots going into heaven. What is it called?
It's
playing robots into heaven. It's yeah. Called. So I just put that up. I'm like, what's the better cover? And almost unanimously, everyone was like, oh, second one, the robots into heaven one. I'm like, what?
Everyone said it.
It's a hard photo. It's a good photo. But God, that is awesome.
I think it's
who's the one that was like, oh, if you get rid of the text on Big Hammer, it's even
that
better.
Was LED.
I love the text.
I
on
love
Big
the text.
Hammer.
It's right. So well
what
placed. It's so well done.
I disagreed with that. I thought the text looked cool, personally. However,
you guys are killing
thank
me.
You for
join the Patreon.
Thank you
if
for
you
generally
agree that Big Hammer's cooler than the album cover.
Guys, pay us money if you agree with us.
Also,
and like and comment
also
and
join the Patreon if you agree with me, and then we can all bond about how we all agree together.
Join the Patreon if you don't like any of us and you want to give us money to make fun of us. That's
join the Patreon if you're living and breathing.
Gotcha. Gotcha.
What'd you guys think of the last James Blake record?
I'm gonna be honest. I never heard it. I never listened
Sleep
to
Aid
it.
One?
No.
The fucking
the one
no.
Friends That Break Your Heart.
The one with the like weird album cover.
The head on the side.
Yeah, it scares me. I enjoyed it. I don't think it was anything crazy.
I
probably get like a 7 when it came out. I'd probably drop it just cuz not a whole lot of songs were like super standout-ish to me. There were some definite songs where I'm like, "Oh, that's like fucking actually a really good pop song and it sounds really good." Like Famous Last Words, Life Is Not The Same.
I was just going to
say,
dude, I wasn't the biggest fan either, but Life Is Not The Same is like one
beautiful.
Of my favorite James Blake
great
songs.
Song.
I love
great
that song.
And that
I really like
weird electronic sound.
I really like I'll Come Too.
Yeah.
You know? That's my favorite. That's probably my favorite James Blake song.
I'm going to say what I need. If it's I will say, though, I still don't fucking think, like, I haven't listened to most of his discography, but the songs that I have heard, I don't think anything touches his fucking debut record.
His debut is awesome. I still think The Color.
I never learned to share is such a fun
song. I think The Color and Anything is still my personal favorite album of his. I guess that's a controversial opinion. I feel like most big James Blake fans agree with me, but like general consensus is that it's his weakest album. But I personally love it, so.
I like that we all have a different a favorite James Blake album. That's kind of funny.
What's your favorite, Jake?
Overgrown.
Right.
What's your favorite song off of that again? Is it Digital Lion? You know how he says that.
And I kind of like the intro, Overgrown. Like that's a banger.
Jackson, when you go down to eat the burrito, it just looks really funny.
Tell me how the fucking balloon head.
Boom, 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 boom.
That's what it looks like.
Boom, 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 boom.
It's penis music, bro. Bro made penis music for his debut single of his new album.
It is very close to sounding like... It's like very close to that.
See that.
Will, do you think there will ever be a song that is more penis-y than Butterfly Prowler?
I don't think so.
It's going to be hard to top. It's going to be really hard to top.
It's weird because penis music is a weird category. Like, you can make bad music. Like, not bad music, like, because it's a good song. You can make goofy-sounding music, like... I found
because Butterfly Prowler is a fucking banger. That song is awesome.
Penis music, you have to find this is weird penis niche music. Where it's like it's penisy, but it's not on purpose, and it still sounds good. That's the combination.
It's so funny that the three of us can be like, you know, when it sounds penisy, and we all just get it.
I have to make a video essay about penis music.
That's true. So you do.
You have to. Yeah.
Wait.
I forgot about that.
I didn't. You know what we did forget about, though? Jackson, you have to do your fucking punishment, remember? Yeah,
Ironically, I did forget about that until you just said it. I haven't had a car, but I'll find time to do it now.
Yeah!
All right.
What was that?
It just says, beat makes me want to rob a museum. That's penis music right there.
Yeah, I don't
that's
know.
A little too
that's
far.
A, would you say 100 gets?
That was a little too far
though?
Because that was too intentional. Yeah, I think that penis music loses its penisness when it's intentionally goofy. It has to be a genuine, authentic, came from the penis music.
Came from the penis.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Came from the penis.
That'd be the title.
Great episode title.
Came from the risky. Penis dot 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 music.
We're trying to be nice. We're trying to be nice. We're trying to get monetized. We're getting on YouTube's good side. We're getting close. Getting close. Shout out to
Susan Wojcicki. Has to be on our side.
Did she step down?
Did she? No, no.
Yeah, she did.
No. Oh wait, did she?
She did.
Yeah, she did. You're right. Oh my god, she did.
You guys definitely don't have YouTube contacts, dummy.
Do you have a YouTube contact?
What is a YouTube contact?
It's a person you contact for YouTube and be like, hey, yo, do you kill this guy?
Oh,
sick. That's what that means.
Hey, yo, do you kill this guy?
You would.
That's just imagine like the
imagine.
Fucking, Google,
it's
show
like,
me this
like,
guy's balls, please.
It's like, hey, this guy made a video making fun of me. Can you, like, kill him?
Hey. What the fuck? There it was.
Have you guys seen any of the clips from the new season of Eric Andre Show?
I see that he gets like maybe the most famous people he's ever gotten the show. I saw that he got Hanks, and
he got Jaden Smith,
he got Donald Glover,
John Hamm. I've been watching them like just on YouTube, like the clips and stuff. It has really lost its charm because Hannibal,
bro.
A, he doesn't have Hannibal anymore, which is a major loss, and the new guy like is barely a part of it and totally is not carrying his weight.
Yeah.
And also just like it's kind of turned into like he has to up it every season. So now it's more just like a I don't know.
How weird and quirky is this?
Yeah, it's turned into like a Jackass kind of thing where it's like we're going to play really loud sounds and this guy's going to get scared. It's like
But the thing is that it's like the people that he interviews 100% know what they're going into. Like
he's too famous. It's past the threshold.
Yeah. I mean, that was the charm of, like, the first two seasons of Eric Andre's show was that no one knew what it was, you know? And, like, everyone thought it was just an actual talk show.
Once it passed, season three was really the breaking point, because that's when he had, like, his movie come out, and then, like, I think he was a part of all the Jackass movies, like, the newer ones. And so it was just, like, he was a big name. He was going on talk shows talking about how he tricked people into going on a show. So it was, like, publicly known that he was, like, I'm going to try to get you on your show and you're not going to know about it.
Right.
It's, like, well, now everyone's in on it.
Well,
and
Eric Andre
just...
has, like, talked about it. Like, he has talked about it himself where he thinks the show lost its original charm. And so he's kind of had to, like, adapt the show and kind of change it over time. And you're right. It is more of, like, a prank show now. But with, like, a... still has this lens of, like, this is a talk show, but it's mainly a prank show. So.
Yeah. You can kind of tell, too. It's like, because the celebrities don't say
I haven't seen any of the new episodes, by the way. I just want to say that.
especially the Donald Glover one, it feels like they just kind of go into it knowing what's going to happen and just, like, it's almost like a challenge for them to get through it where it's like, all right, I'm going to try not to react to these things, like, too bad. You know, there's
can
no more
you survive
moments.
The interview? Okay. The fucked up and twisted mind of Eric Andre.
He'll kill you.
This guy will kill you. Yeah, so.
Well.
Rip that show, yep. I guess.
But you know what show yep. I want to watch? I haven't watched it, but all of my friends have said that I need to. The Bear. Have you guys seen The Bear? Have you heard about
it? I watched half of season one, and then I stopped watching it, not because I wanted to, but because I didn't subscribe to Hulu anymore.
Oh, no.
But
do you have
it
FX,
was actually
though?
Really fucking good. No.
Fuck you! Yeah.
Fuck you.
The Bear, it was very, very good, though. All the acting's great in it, and then the fucking, what's his face from Loiter Squad? The taller dude.
Taco?
You know what I'm talking about? No, the guy who plays Catchphrase Loiter Jones.
Never watched Loiter Squad.
Oh, wait.
Catchphrase Jones? You know what I'm talking about? It's Lionel.
Oh, really? Lionel is in that show.
He's really good in it. He plays like a pastry chef. And he's awesome.
Oh, is he the donut guy that like...
He's the donut guy.
Donuts?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I've seen a little bit of it. I know about The Bear because it just like... Jeremy Allen White is his name?
He plays...
I don't know.
He plays
the
Marcus.
Lead guy?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, he plays Marcus. Thank you.
Jeremy... I think his name's Jeremy Allen White or whatever. He's the most like... unattractive, sexy person I've ever seen in my entire life.
That's such a good way of putting
who
it.
Who is
actually.
This?
And like,
who is this?
I put
the lead in
it's
it.
The main guy.
Oh yeah,
like,
yeah.
I tell people all the time about this, and they're like, "No, that's actually facts." Like he's weirdly like hot, but he also like weirdly looks like a melted candle. Like he's like, he's
yeah.
winning life, bro. Shout out.
I mean, shout out that guy for real.
Yeah,
yeah.
Shout out
he's
that guy
new
for
Iron
real.
Claw movie too. I'm so excited.
The thing about the bear
it's the
that's just
movie, A24.
The thing about the bear that's just interesting to me, and this is coming from a guy who has not seen it at all, but I just remember the first season came out like last year or like the year before last year, and I just remember it kind of being like, oh yeah, it's a pretty good show. Like people are just like, yeah, I like it. I'm definitely gonna watch it when the second season comes out or whatever. And then this new season comes out, and like on Twitter, I'm seeing like Succession level like fan reaction to the fucking Bear, and it's just
I've heard it's great. I know that in season one, I didn't get there get far enough into it to see this, but there's an episode that is all filmed like it's one take, which I think is really cool.
I watched a video essay about it, and that's how I
oh,
know
really?
My Bear knowledge of it, and it
that's
looks
so cool.
fascinating.
Yeah,
like.
That's just
maybe,
so hard to do.
Even, maybe we need to start watching
like
The Bear.
It's one take.
Maybe, guys.
It is. It's not like 1917. It is one take.
Oh, the whole thing is actually one take?
From what I remember, it's the whole thing is just one take, just straight up.
Fuck, okay.
Like, not even 1917.
It's kind of like the first scene from 12 Angry Men when it's all one take. Remember? When it's panning around
the room.
Finally
watched 12 Angry Men.
Guys, that movie's so damn good. It's so good.
It's so fucking good, man. That
you guys need to get so many bitches.
That bit where they all stand up, never fuck it. Like, my fucking... I geek over that. It's
dude,
so good.
I like, low-key started tearing up at the end. I won't say what happens at the end if you haven't seen it, but...
I don't remember what happens at the end.
He rips the photo. That's all I'll say.
That isn't... It's been a while since I've seen it.
Does anyone care about 12 Angry Men spoilers? It came out in 1957.
Yeah, I was gonna say, what do you wait? Like, what do you spoil? This is
yeah,
like the oldest
it,
movie ever.
He rips up. It's like the main
spoiler
guy.
Spoiler alert, they save the princess.
The main guy who is voting guilty the whole time that's clearly not liked the main villain. He like clearly has had something against him. He keeps referring to him as a kid, and he throws down his wall at the end that has all the info from the case, and out comes a photo of him and his child who he said that like he hasn't seen in 2 years or something like
right.
that because he clearly was not a good father to him, and he starts crying, and he's like, not guilty, not guilty.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about
oh,
that.
Oh,
that shit's
what
so
the
good.
Fucking Family Guy was referencing in that one courtroom thing?
Bro.
What?
Oh, dude, that makes so much sense. What the hell? Okay.
Bro, what are you talking about?
Because there's the scene, there's like a Family Guy episode where they, oh, is that what they're referencing?
What are you fucking talking about?
Dude.
What Family Guy episode?
Bro, just,
there's a Family
bro.
Guy episode where it's when fucking Adam West is like, they think he killed someone.
What
and then
fuck?
Everyone's in a courtroom trying to like figure it out. And then, oh, I forget what it was. He was like, He's like, I don't like those bare-lipped people. He's like, I only trust people with mustaches or something. He's like, do you trust me now? And he pulls out his mustache. He's like, not guilty. Not guilty. And you said it in the exact same way.
I mean,
is that what
they're referencing? Probably were referencing. Yes! They probably were referencing that, but it was definitely nothing like that happened in the movie. It's not like the guy went, I'm actually good now. And he's
not guilty bit is definitely a fucking reference.
And is the gimmick of the thing, it was like everyone's voting innocent except one guy
yes.
voting guilty?
Everyone's no, it's
that's the
around.
Same thing in the
no,
show.
It's the other way around.
It's the other way around. Everyone's voting guilty, and then it's one guy who votes innocent, and it's the whole movie.
That's the show.
And it's the whole,
okay, that's the episode.
And the whole movie is him trying to convince everyone.
No, you guys don't understand, because Brian wants to vote innocent, but the rest of the family guys don't want to do it.
It's a genius concept.
I've seen the movie.
12 Family Guys.
I find it so funny that Jake watched that whole episode that was probably an entire, like fucking, what do you call rip of 12 Angry Men, and the whole time he was just like,
well,
this
hey,
is a really good story.
They do parodies of the Star Wars movies all the time. I'm like, I don't fucking know what happens. You guys can just lie to me and say this happens. I'd be like, yeah, sure, I believe it.
Oh, that's so fucking funny.
That makes so much sense. Okay. 12 Angry Men. Nice.
You guys
Well, I want to listen, because we talked about Hulu. I want to bring up Hulu. Have you guys heard the news about Hulu? With a specific show on Hulu?
What
Futurama?
Show? Oh, that's
no, what happened?
They're making new episodes of Futurama.
Yeah. I heard about that.
Just like,
did you not know
just,
that?
Just casually.
It's the same people like, that made the old Futurama episode, so it's like the same team, but... All right, Futurama has the... I saw someone say this on Twitter, and I cannot agree more. Futurama is maybe the show that has the most, like, satisfying emotional endings just for them to bring the show back again. And then
how did Futurama end?
Undo it. Well, it ended with Fry and what's her name? What's the one on?
Leela.
Yeah, Leela. Mm-hmm. They get frozen in time, and they like live an entire life, like while everyone else is frozen in time, and they realize that they're happy just being with one another. And then I think the old scientist guy is like, "Wait, you could go back."
Professor Farnsworth.
Yeah, yeah. Professor Farnsworth is like, "Wait, you all have been frozen in time. If you want to go back, you'll forget everything you've ever known, but you'll still meet each other." And then Fry and Leela are like, "I'm okay with that," because they like truly love each other, they'll forever be together.
Loki making me emotional thinking about it. That was a really
no. Seriously, play. I was gonna say that was a really good way to end that. Super
satisfying, super emotionally potent, great way to end it. But they're just bringing it back. So I guess they're going to completely just be like, man, it didn't actually work and we're still going to do Futurama, or they're going to, that's the like canonical ending and they're just doing like bonus episodes or something. I don't know.
This is the Hulu ending.
Oh, yeah.
They bring the up that like, we're on Hulu now. Like when Family Guy talks about Fox all the time.
Yeah.
I'm on Family Guy a lot right now, man.
Yeah, you are. We can tell.
Did you guys see the thing about the creator of Futurama and The Simpsons? Fucking Matt Groening was in the OceanGate submarine like weeks before Titanic thing.
No.
He went on an excursion in the OceanGate thing. I it might have been in the Titanic, but he was in it. He was like in the submarine.
Did you see Mr. Beast's Twitter?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, what is that guy
got
doing?
Invited. No, he was like, "Oh, I got invited to the thing," and I just said no.
I saw that, but then the screenshot was a text that he sent inviting someone else to it.
It actually turned out to be a screenshot from his friend who invited him. So it was his friend who invited him, but for whatever reason, Mr. Beast thought it'd be a good idea to get his friend's screenshot of it instead of the screenshot of him receiving the text. I don't know. It was weird. This is gonna be like the new version of like when rich people like this is gonna be the new version of like celebrities being like, "I was supposed to be on the 9/11 flight," but instead it's
that's literally what the thing said.
But just think about it. Somewhere in an alternate timeline, both Mr. Beast and Matt Groening died in the submarine accident instead of a bunch of billionaires.
Dude, how would we? All right. It already got a shit ton of news coverage, but if
whatever you're gonna say.
But if Mr. Beast died, how would the world react?
We held the world's biggest funeral for $2 million.
50% of the world would be like, "Oh my god, this is so sad," and the other 50% that use Twitter frequently would be like, "Good, he had a lot of money, he should be dead."
Yeah, it would be the same shit as it is now, where it's just like people.
It actually was kind of crazy to like see how unhinged Twitter got and like the response to that, because there were so many people that were like, because like a night, like say what you will, like yeah, there were billionaires, like you know, but like also like a 19-year-old dude just died, like he didn't fucking do anything.
You see, he was trying to break a world record for the. Like the deepest depths to ever solve a Rubik's cube.
Really, the 19-year-old. Yes.
Yeah,
He also was on the record. He also was. His aunt said that he was horrified to go on it and only wanted to do it to make his dad happy for Father's Day. So.
Oh man.
That's hope you guys feel saddest, real happy on Twitter
just the
now,
saddest
guys.
Fucking thing that I've ever heard.
Yeah. Fucking.
Hope you guys feel real good on Twitter now.
Jackson, what are your opinions on the billionaires dying? What are your thoughts?
Oh man, wouldn't it be crazy if that shit didn't explode? I don't know.
My personal opinion
is that billionaires suck, but it also sucks when people die. So I don't think that's a hot take.
Hot take? Death is kind of crazy.
Having a lot of money equals bad person. Luke on demand, 2023.
Yes!
Hassan Piker has a lot of money, but he's one of the good ones.
Did you guys hear that he lives in a house? Remember that?
Show everyone.
Me when I buy a house.
Guys, I had a what was I fucking gonna say? I was gonna talk about a TV show thing or something. I watched another movie recently. I don't know if I mentioned this on the podcast. Did I talk about me seeing Vertigo? I watched Vertigo in the theater, actually.
Oh, I haven't seen Vertigo, actually, but what did you think?
Pretty cool. Pretty cool. I actually really enjoyed it. It's a very good-looking movie. Some of the effects for the time, I can tell that they weren't meant to look dated, but I just thought they looked really stylized and cool from like a modern perspective. I do think the ending of the movie is kind of unnecessary, but overall, pretty good. Thumbs up. I like it.
Yeah.
It's been a hot minute since I've seen Vertigo.
You've seen Vertigo?
I have.
What do you think of it?
Film. I remember enjoying it, but it was in that time in high school where I'm watching them like, oh, time to write a 700-page paper about what you just saw.
Oh,
fuck
yeah.
Fuck this movie.
That's the thing with the
I had to do that with the older
Matrix,
Hitchcock
movies.
Remember?
Oh, yeah. With the allegory
right,
of the cave. That's the thing with those older Hitchcock movies is that, like, especially I remember when I first saw Psycho, I was like, yeah, it's good. But it's been parodied and done so many times since then, it's kind of hard to put yourself in the mindset of, like, okay, this was the first to ever do this, you know?
Right. No, yeah, that makes total sense. It's like when you watch an old
It's like when you listen to
movie,
Weezer, and then you try to listen to any other Midwest emo, and you're like, damn, this is just horrible.
Oh, shit, speaking of Weezer.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, that is called a transition.
Yeah.
I delivered a pizza to Hurley.
He did.
Can I say
what Jackson said whenever it happened? His exact wording. hold on, I'm looking for it right now. He said, "I just delivered a pizza to Hurley from Lost and the Weezer album."
Lost in the Weezer album.
I just like that you put both of those in the same playing field.
Both.
I didn't know if you guys would know who he was from Lost.
I said, no fucking way. Do you have proof? And you said his $15 tip.
Dude, he tipped crazy good, and was very nice.
Did he live in like a? Was his nouse? The nouse. Was
his address?
Yeah. Was his house super nice? Did it have like a swimming pool?
It was very. I didn't get to see it.
Very recognizable
it was...
shrub on the corner of the road that everyone knows what it looks like if you mention it, or like, does he have like that one tree that hangs to the left of his house that like overhangs the
he
driveway?
He has a Trump 2024
we're talking about.
Flag
yeah.
out of his. Out.
Is that it? Yeah, is that what you're talking about?
Guys, can you please mute that? I accidentally said flag without the L on accident. So please mute that. I did
can
not
keep
mean
this
to
part
do
in,
that.
Though?
Yes.
Can we keep this part?
I meant to say flag, and I did not say the L because I misspoke. Sorry. So you're going to have to do that. I was trying to make a joke about how he had a Trump 2024 flag, and then it turned out that I just said a slur on accident. So
he has a what?
Yeah.
What hanging?
sorry. Trump 2024. What? Oh my god. Oh.
I'm like genuinely right, now, embarrassed. Now, by Jackson, that. I'm so here's sorry. The plan.
Cut that out.
Isolate it. Isolate it.
No! 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 Enhance.
Now, Jackson, if you were funny, you'd send me a email later tonight. Like, don't say anything. But, like, hey, don't have anything in it, but just put in the subject line the audio, and then I'll send it.
Flag.
You're like blackmailing me.
Flag without the L. Oh, that's the name of the podcast. Flag without the L.
Luke's future in the subject.
Flag without the L. Can we name it that, or is that too much?
We can't name it that. We cannot name the episode that.
Oh my god, guys, I'm sorry.
You know how Tyler Creator songs? They have like no. That's a bad example.
Random disclaimer.
What's like a subheading?
Hey,
like
songs that don't do anything that I said in this song. This okay, it's fucking don't fiction. Say, if hey, anything don't happens, any don't fucking Luke blame Stone me. White America. Fuck Bill O'Reilly.
Don't say any of the words Luke Stone just said. You will be canceled on Twitter for the same people that hate the billionaires.
Welcome anyways, Hurley's house. I didn't get to see his house because he had one of those like gates that like fully surrounded it. It was like super locked down.
Luke is shamed.
I'm embarrassed. I'm sorry.
He feels shamed.
Because I genuinely did not mean to do that. Imagine Jackson edits it. He's like, Luke, you didn't even say that. Like,
where
you
the
just
hell?
Thought you did.
I tried to.
I didn't
anyways, Hurley's house, there was a bunch of security cameras around it, and it had a big, like, fence, so he seemed, like, kind of holed away, but he was very nice. I delivered him his pizzas.
Shout out. Cool guy. $15 tip. That's it? He's probably a millionaire, and he only gave a $15 tip? Wow. Sorry, I'm really making fun of these Twitter people. I gotta relax.
Jake is not having it.
Not having it, man.
Jake, you're so capitalism filled today. I had a pretty crazy story. I had a pretty crazy story. It's not even real.
Comically was, large money. No,
that was
not.
Huge. That's what you said. It's a fucking massive dollar bill.
Comically large $100 bill.
I had not a crazy story.
You know they make it bigger because it's more money.
I had not a crazy story, but as that. But
Twitter be like.
Oh, no.
I'm done.
Twitter be like, I hate money. Anyway.
You guys ever see the fucking Elon Musk, like Asian Elon Musk, like deepfake, Yilong Ma? Where he's like, I'm being so serious. There's this guy that has a TikTok account, and he's like from Vietnam, and he deepfakes Elon Musk's face on him, and his name is Yilong Ma. And he does this thing where he's like, money! And he like throws money at the camera.
And he goes, I'm Elon
this is real! I'm being so serious! I'm gonna send you a Yilong Ma clip, right? I can't believe
Jake,
you guys don't know Yilong
Ma.
Jake,
you've never seen this? What?
No, I don't have TikTok.
But Elon Ma is universal.
Oh. He's transcendent.
Elon Ma.
While you're
someone cover
oh
for
God,
me.
Guys, I'm still embarrassed.
It's okay, Luke. It's fine. We know you have a pure soul. Anyway, speaking of deepfake, how do we feel about Juice WRLD and YBN Cordae? Y'all hear about that?
No. What happened?
The what?
YBN Cordae had a music video. It had a song featuring Juice WRLD, and he deepfaked Juice WRLD's face onto his during the music video.
Oh my God.
With Hassan featuring
was
Juice
it like
World?
In a was it like
a
in a
song
the
featuring
heart part
Juice
five
World.
Way
you
or?
Thought I said Hassan you fucking dummy bro
was it
Hassan?
I'm sorry I was in the middle of watching a Yilong Ma clip
was it like a was it a kind of like a heart part five music video type beat where it was
no
like,
it's him walking down the like it's kind of, all right. So this is gonna be a weird thing. You know the scene in Old Boy where they're fighting in the hallway.
Yes.
Imagine that, but it's facing forward, and instead of fighting in a hallway, it's business people freaking out, like just throwing papers and shit. So YBN Cordae is like rapping, and then I think it's supposed to be like every once in a while, it's a flash between him, and then a flash deep fake of Juice WRLD. Flash of him, flash of deep fake of Juice WRLD.
That's so
and
fucking
people are like,
weird.
People are weird about it. I'm curious if you. I'm surprised you haven't heard about this. It's a big music thing.
I mean,
the Yilong Ma clip has been sent into the Discord chat.
I just think it's
thank God.
I think it's a little silly that this is less a debate about whether we should use that for AI like deep faking or whatever. Or well, I guess this kind of goes into a similar thing that people were talking about from the Flash movie. Is that a spoiler for the Flash?
I talked about it on the other. I guess it doesn't count up yet because my
okay.
Dad
well,
all hair, right.
Well,
this I is talk about it on our podcast, but the deepfakes with the Flash and how I gave the Flash a one because reviving dead people for money is an atrocity.
I'm sorry. What were we saying? I was laughing at Elon Ma.
Dude, isn't this so cool though? He's like,
that's pretty funny.
Money.
Good too.
Money.
I love the way he says money. I love it so much.
Who did DC pray really hard to have come back from the dead? Like in the intro of this video.
What?
Christopher Reeves. No. What are you talking about? He's talking about the Flash. It was.
I get it. I misinterpreted yeah. what he said.
It was Christopher Reeves and fucking like I think one other guy maybe.
Oh wow.
No, it was also Adam West and the guy who played the original Flash in like the TV show.
Not Adam West, but the mayor from Family Guy.
The mayor from Family Guy. It looks like that one meme video that someone made before Spider-Man came out, where it was like a fake Tobey Maguire like thing. You guys know what I'm talking about? If you've seen it, you know what I'm talking about. But yeah,
only real ones know.
I guess I feel the same about the Juice WRLD cameo as I do about that, where it's not good. We shouldn't be doing that.
I think the word. Well, all right. What happened in the movie? Like, were they coming back as like?
They were like barely in it. It was like totally fanfare. There's like so the thing with the Flash is when he goes too fast, he enters this like weird area where he can like jump to different multiverses that are in these little bubbles. So it's like this moment where all the bubbles from all these multiverses.
That's literally gravity falls.
We got to see what
was
literally
a gravity
one.
Falls bit.
Damn. Okay, well, I think it was a part of the comics in the 60s.
DC
but...
was literally... Okay, I was going to say, like, DC was really like, man, Spider-Man popping off, we're just going to take that and put it in our pocket.
But it pretty much was that, though. But yeah. Like, even with Spider-Man, though, like, it was, like, cool because, like... I actually was just watching a video about this. Eddie Brubeck and his brother have their own channel called Brubeck. That's really, really good. And they have this video about, like, multiverse fatigue and how, like, all these multiverse movies are getting tiring.
I saw that. I saw it in my recommended.
Like, with the Spider-Verse movies and also, like, some of the, like, the live-action Spider-Man movies and the earlier multiverse movies, like, Everything Everywhere, it's, like, a multiverse movie, but it's always centered around one character. But with, like, the Flash and, like, all this, like, the Doctor Strange shit, it all just ends up being, like, getting to the next movie. Like, it's all trying to connect... Yeah. Everything together for like
the thing that's so frustrating about Marvel in particular, and I guess DC now, I hope James Gunn does it right and makes it interesting because they're kind of revamping their whole thing. But the thing with Marvel that's annoying is it doesn't feel like that's what made, despite what you may think about Endgame as a movie. Like, the thing that made Endgame cool was that it felt like an end to a story. You know
Endgame
what I mean?
Was good.
Endgame has been getting some unjustified hate on Twitter, I think. I don't think it's nearly as good as Infinity War, but
no
I still
way.
Think it's
people
good.
On Twitter hate something? Come on, bro.
Dude, this would never happen in real life.
But I think when people are like, think people on Twitter hate something, I think it's kind of silly because... A lot of people genuinely don't like Endgame and don't like certain things. It's just Twitter is the place to hate on stuff. So you just go there to do it. But anyway, I feel like a lot of people don't like Endgame and I kind of understand why. I still think it's a good movie, but it had good finality to it. Like you watch that and you're like, okay, this is where Marvel is done and it's over, right? But... No, what they do is, oh, how can we connect this to the next movie that we do? How
it's
can
all
we
stepping
keep,
stones.
How
yeah.
can we keep making this forever? And so nothing, when you watch something and you know that it's not going to end for the foreseeable future, there's no payoff. Stakes. There's no payoff. It's the same thing with a TV show that keeps going on forever. Like there's barely any payoff because there'll be a plot twist or like a what do you call it whenever it's like
flag without the L?
No, what do you call it?
It's, I could have swore that's what you're talking.
It's whenever
about,
a show so. Cliffhanger when a show ends on a cliffhanger or a movie ends on a cliffhanger if. It's going into the next movie and it has no finality to it and it's just leading to the next thing. There's no payoff at all. And so Marvel has little to no payoff and it makes me not want to watch it because it's just stupid. I don't like it. I haven't been interested in Marvel movies other than Spider-Verse, which I still need to watch.
So good.
Other than like stuff like that, I've not been interested in like MCU for like since Endgame. Like literally, I saw the new Spider-Man, but that's all I've seen.
And it's just so much content. I want to see the new
Guardians. Yeah. It's like you have to devote so much for stuff that is not even that good anymore. Like I feel like I don't know if it's because people are fatigued and the shows are actually good. It's just people are sick and tired of seeing all these shows, or if they're just like actually not nearly as good as they used to be. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't know. Because when Marvel first started, like the MCU, it felt fresh, but it just is so overdone now.
So, yeah, I don't know. I mean,
Jake, thoughts?
I think people are going to get tired of it.
I don't watch superhero movies, so I really don't have a dog in this fight. I never even saw Endgame. I don't even know what happens.
They all live and
Iron Man dies.
Thanos just snaps and his that dick gets does happen. Oh,
shit, that's sick.
Did I know, right?
That's dope.
Guys, I had
thinking about that now.
Shit, I'll be right back.
This is
God damn.
Anyone got a pee? What was I gonna say? This is not a crazy story at all, but it was more sad than anything. So late last night, I was up and I had food cravings, and so there was a
like you said that like you were pregnant.
I wanted some
pickles dipped in a Wendy's Frosty, and I was in it.
Ugh, fucking that's gross. Fucking
disgusting. That is the grossest thing I've ever heard. You
pickles
say.
You never heard of cravings?
Pickles and Wendy's.
That's a thing.
No, stop. I'm not gonna get gas.
That's not a thing. That's not a thing. It's fries in a Frosty. You fucking
no.
It's not a pickle.
People have asked.
No, it's no. Who has done that? You're weird. Look it up.
What are you talking? Yeah, what? No, this
I've
is
never
not
heard
thing.
That ever.
This is not a thing. Pickles and Frosty?
I've heard fries and Frosty.
You know what? Why don't you get me pregnant and we find out, huh?
Promise?
Wait, am I stupid?
Yeah.
Anyway, why? It's fries.
That confused two things.
It's fries and a Frosty.
The limited edition Wendy's Pickle Rick Frosty?
What?
Did my brain just stop working?
Bro.
Jake, it's fries and a Frosty. Pickle and a Frosty.
No,
would be...
it is fries. I know it is fries and a Frosty. I know. But I have heard of some pregnant people saying, no, pickles and a Frosty
that
is actually good.
That sounds awful.
I think it sounds gross, too. I'm not defending. I'm not like, yeah, that's just...
I know, but I just have not... Like, the way you said it was as if, like, this is a common craving.
It was like a common thing, yeah.
Oh, your mom's didn't crave a pickle with... Whenever she was fucking pregnant with your...
Okay. Luke, what were you going to talk about?
So I really wanted cookies, and I didn't have anything to make cookies at my apartment. So there's an Insomnia Cookies that's open until 1 a.m., so I ordered it for delivery.
Also, hot take about Insomnia Cookies. Closes way too early to be called Insomnia
All right,
Cookies.
That's so
know.
True.
I've never heard of this place
that's
in my
so
whole
true.
Life.
All right, Insomnia, it's like, do you know what Crumble Cookies is? Do you have Crumble?
Crumble Cookies actually sucks, but yeah, I do know what you're talking about.
All right, sometimes they're good, because they do new flavors every week, but sometimes
they're
also
just,
sucks.
It's too much. It's way
too
much.
It's too sweet. It's too sweet a lot of the time.
Yeah.
I prefer Insomnia, because you kind of know what you're going to get, and it's cheaper. but I just want some chocolate chip cookies, so I ordered some Insomnia, and I was sitting at my apartment. I was like, damn, they're about to close. Why the fuck are my cookies not here? And I looked, and I had ordered it for fucking pickup, and it was $12.59, and I was like, oh my god. And so I called the store, and they answered. And they answered. And I said, hey, are you guys still open? They're like, well, we're about to close. And I said, I'm Luke. I made the order.
It's me.
I ordered it for pickup. I meant to put delivery. I'm so sorry. Can you all just stick around for a little bit? And the dude said yes. I was so hyped. So he worked 5 minutes overtime, but I got my cookies and my damn milk.
Right. I thought you were gonna say, "Is like, no, yeah, I live 20 minutes away."
No, but the thing is I was gonna be like, I was so nervous because I thought I was gonna waste money having ordered these cookies, and I just don't get them at all. That would have been so sad.
That's fucked up.
Yeah. It's not an interesting story at all, but I just thought I'd tell it.
If I was working and someone called me and was like, hey, did I have to tell you about the guy who came in after we closed the coffee shop I worked at?
No. I think the guy, whenever I called him, though, he thought I was drunk because I was like, hey, can I, like, come over there? I'm so sorry. I thought it was, like, hey, delivery. He was like, yeah, sure, buddy. You can come here, man.
Yeah, sure.
Like, that's how he said it. That's how he said it. I was like, this dude definitely thinks you're drunk, I'm, like, and he's drunk. Like,
oh, this guy's gonna get DUI if he drives through the
police. Yeah, he was probably thinking, like, this dude is fucked up, but yeah, sure.
Like,
yeah,
this guy's gonna get DUI. I'll save him the court date. I'll just pull up, and then he did, and then... Beautiful day. That's so funny. Shout out to what was the crumble cookie guy name? What was his name?
Insomnia Cookies, actually.
Fuck. Yeah, same thing.
I don't remember.
You fool!
Same shit, different smell.
I actually have a crazy employee story. I forgot about this. So I was opening at the AMC the other day. I was working the box office, and I got there, and there was already people working the concessions who were making the food, like pre-making the food that were there, because I was just doing box office. But I go to walk in, this lady's waiting outside, and she's like, she's on the phone, like on the speakerphone with someone. She's like, hey, excuse me. I'm like, yeah, what's going on? She's like, I heard that you guys are showing, like, I can't remember what it was called. It was some dumb movie title called, like, I Saw Freedom or something like that. Like, I heard you guys are showing I Saw Freedom on July 3rd. And I was like, oh, I haven't heard about that, but I can go inside and check for you. So I walk in and I check, and sure enough, we're not showing it, but there's in select theaters, they're showing this movie called I Saw Freedom. It's not called that, but it's like something in the along those lines. On like from like July 3rd to July 6th or something. And I'm like, hey, they're not showing it here, they're showing it at this other location. And she continues to go on this 10-minute long rant while I'm standing in the doorway waiting to open about, like, how this movie is about, like, what's it called? Human trafficking, and how, like, the government is in on it, and goes on this spiel where she's like, and you don't even know the half of it. The rabbis are selling children for half the price of the organs, and you don't even know. I'm like, what is going on? And finally, I'm like, all right, great. Well, I have to go in and work. She's like, oh, I'm so sorry, but do your research. And then I go inside, my manager's like, dude, I'm so sorry. She was here yesterday. I already clocked you in. Crawlers. You're on the clock.
She was here yesterday.
She was there the day before. And she, I guess she crossed, like, I was talking for so long that my manager had clocked me in when she saw me talking to her, because she knew that that's I wasn't going to get paid. Because I'm supposed to clock myself in, and I hadn't had a chance to yet. It's like, and so she was like, don't worry, right, you got paid for that interaction.
It's the Viagra Boy song in real life, Creepy Crawlers.
What's so funny about that?
I can't believe it.
So was she specifically asking for July 3rd of when the movie was coming out? Did she specifically ask that?
Yeah.
So why did she come in the day before to ask the same thing?
She wanted to make sure that it was a different date. She's like, all right, maybe July 4th it wasn't playing. Maybe July 3rd it'll play.
That was the thing. She's like, I don't know if I'll have time to see it. Maybe the 6th? And I was like,
she's
going to
come tomorrow, and she's going to be like,
why the fuck would they play a movie like that in AMC?
I don't know, dude.
It has nothing to do... Like, it has the guy from fucking some movie in it. Like, it's like a limited edition thing that they're running. Honestly, it probably has nothing to do with what she's talking about. I think that she was just wanting to tell about human trafficking. It's probably about human trafficking that actually happened, because it's like a biopic.
Uh-huh.
But, like, then she went on this whole thing about rabbis, and, like, and I was like, okay, now we're getting into the bad territory. Oh! Now we're getting into the gamer talk.
Gamer talk.
So, like, gamer, you know, no bueno, talk. But...
Core, if you will.
What if you were like... I'm Jewish. What have you said that?
Oh, actually, I'm a rabbi. No, but also my boss at the pizza place that I work at is fucking so based, and he was telling me all about how he's like, he loves Cave World, and how he's like, he's such a big fan of Viagra Boys, and he's like an Idols fan. He was playing like Bjork when we were closing last night, and he'll do this thing where he'll be like, well, like, it's just me and him, we're closing, he'll be like, oh man, play whatever you want, I want to hear what you're listening to. And so I'll just like play, like, I was playing fucking Sparks by Beach House when we were closing.
Butterfly Prowler.
Dude, I should. No, but he just like plays the most bass shit, where I'm like, oh my god, like he was playing Billy Not Really, like, while we were open.
That's a bass.
While we were open.
Not really. That's really sick, dude.
No, Billy. Not really.
I wish I had cool, like, less people I worked with that listen to music like that.
Yeah, I know. He's the best.
At the radio station, for me, it's different, obviously, because they all like kind of know that stuff. But at my second job, where I run replay camera, it's funny. Whenever I was like, yeah, I'm going to a Black Mini concert, they were like, what the fuck? fuck are you talking about? Or like, yeah, or like the one that they both didn't know, thankfully, was Death Grips. Not that they listened to Death Grips, but Death Grips are just so ingrained in meme culture that whenever I told them I was seeing Death Grips, they were like, oh man.
Did I tell you guys a story about when I asked one of my coworkers what his favorite album of all time was?
No.
No, what'd he say?
No? Alright, so we were cleaning once, and it was like, it was getting late, and me and this one guy, I don't know if I should say his real name or not. Someone say a fake name.
Joe Jeffrey.
Alright, Joe Jeffrey. We'll call him Jeffrey. Jeffrey Starship. We'll call him Jeffrey. And I asked Jeffrey, we're just cleaning, I'm like, you know, I don't know much about Jeffrey. Let's try and... I'll make the first video. I was like, yo, Jeffrey, what's your favorite album of all time? He's like, oh, shit. Stopped everything he was doing. Just looked off. And I'm like, oh, if you don't know, like, you just, like, get back to it. He's like, I think I'll get back to you with it. 4 hours go by. I'm about to leave. And he comes up to me. He's like, I think I found it now. And I don't even remember what it was. Like, the name. But I remember it was a... You know how people release albums, but it's just different remixes of the same song?
Yeah.
That's his favorite album of all time.
That's
it was
so
some
awesome,
like
dude.
EDM person. It was like, yeah, this is my favorite album. It's just a bunch of remixes of the same song.
That's really funny. Awesome. That is really funny.
That's really fucking funny,
dude. Like, my favorite album of all time is the one that has, oh god, what's the track list? It's Need to Slow to Pine Grove.
They
Need
did
to
that, dude.
Sped Up Pine Grove.
Jackson, can you give it to us?
Man,
give it to us. Luke will sing it. Give it to us, man. Come on.
The shuffle?
Come on.
Do
man,
the shuffle.
Let me see a video of it first so I don't fuck it up. I saw dude, that song is so fucking good. Like, I'm sorry, but like that shit is like peak.
It's crazy that Jackson caught the curve on that. Oh, he's doing it, ladies and gentlemen. He said, I'm going for it. And then we could put you in like core TikToks. It's more to the side, but you're definitely getting it.
And hold on, now I'm gonna do the sped up version. Now I'm gonna do the ultra sped up version.
It's so funny because me and my friend are so obsessed with that song that we were like before it even fucking, like, they even released that, like, we were online looking for the slowed and sped up versions, and, like, so we had heard that's them funny. Before they even posted it, and it was, like, so funny when it came out, we were like, dude, right. They fucking put it on Spotify!
So far, I feel like that's two things that the Burns men have taught me. Your dad caught me on, the Celsius kick, and you got, Need To by Pine, whatever the fuck it's called. I don't even know what the song's called. I don't give a fuck.
Alright, this can be the last thing. This can be the last thing we talk about because we need to record the bonus here in a second. But what do you guys think about that? This new trend of artists re-releasing old songs on Spotify, but as the slowed or the sped up.
Did you see
version.
What The Neighborhood did?
No.
They just re-uploaded their first album sped up.
Really?
Okay, yeah. Here's what I'll say. I don't mind it at all, because if the artists aren't uploading it, someone's already making a copy online and making money off of it. So I feel like they might as well do it and get the money for the song that they wrote. I mean, it takes 2 seconds to put it into fucking Audacity or whatever and just speed it up. So I think why not?
Well, I think that's my problem with it, is the fact, and it's not the artist's fault.
My problem with it is the artist making money.
Not that artist...
Rich getting richer.
It's not that artists shouldn't be uploading it and making money off their own song, because I do get that. I just think... I don't understand this trend of, like... Well, I think it's mainly... I mean, it's mainly a TikTok thing. I mean, it's because people will be like, oh, well, this song is good... But you know what's even better? This different way that the artist did not intend it to sound like. You know what I mean? That's the only thing that bothers me, because some people will be like, wow, this song is good, but when you slowed it to make it sound like he was fucking King Cruel, that's the better version of the song. When you just slow it down in Audacity and like the bitrate is worse. Like you can enjoy slowed and reverb songs, because I do. I personally love taking songs, putting in Audacity, and making it slower, right? I think it sounds awesome, but it's more of a gimmick, really. I'm not going to listen to an entire thing like that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I get it. That's
so, I think my favorite example of it, do you see what SZA did with Kill Bill?
No.
Oh, she uploaded a single. It was so funny. It's Kill Bill. This ties back to Jeremy's favorite album, right? It's Kill Bill. We have the Kill Bill video, like the video, which is a song on Apple. Yeah. We have the original Kill Bill. We have Kill Bill sped up. We have Kill Bill instrumental. And this is probably my favorite one that's actually kind of based. Kill Bill vocals, where it's just her vocals.
Oh, isolated. That's actually kind of cool. I do like
and
that.
It's just like, it's an album. It's just like, yeah, a little goofy. But it's like,
it's yeah,
like,
there it is, Kill Bill.
Why would you listen to all of that?
Yeah, I don't know. Someone definitely has it on vinyl. And they're
it's
like,
my favorite album, dude.
Kill yeah, Bill remember. Single vinyl.
I will say, before we end, this you is one thing that's annoying me too lately.
On record.
Is that like, I'm starting to get really tired, and this is kind of similar to what me and Luke were talking about earlier with like the shoegaze guy, like, and the memes that he posted. I'm getting real sick of seeing people be like, these are my favorite things of all time, and it's like the same fucking five albums. I'm like, you know, like when I ask for your favorite thing, like, this is kind of, you guys see that interview with Tyler, the Creator, when he's like, when I ask for your favorite thing, I'm not asking you what, like, you think the best thing ever is because it's good music. I'm asking why this piece of art affects you.
Yeah.
Like,
what did Fantano give an 8 or above?
Yeah, it's like I don't want that shit. It's like when Luke says like, oh, my favorite album is like C418's fucking 148. Like, that's like, oh, I don't like that's I've never heard of someone having that as their favorite album. That's so like interesting.
He's got bad
like, what's the okay. deal with that?
What the
or when
Jix
is like
you?
Fucking everything, whatever. Like, that's like a unique. Like, there's right, a story behind that.
He didn't even remember what it was for me. He's like fucking everything, whatever.
Was it Yeezus?
No, it's Get to Heaven, dumb. Fucking
it's
bitch.
Get to Heaven.
That is everything.
Yeah, but you were just like, oh, everything, whatever the fuck.
You didn't even say that.
I didn't remember.
Okay, well, I couldn't remember if it was that one or the newer one, whatever is it, whatever the AI one.
Feel. It's not.
I couldn't remember which it was,
but it's pretty okay. damn close.
Okay, but like what I'm saying, like, I feel like I look at the top fives, the top tens of all of ours, and I go, okay, like, there's some shit. I definitely have more of a basic taste that I need to update, but like. Or like, it's the same thing with movies where I go, oh my god, there's The Godfather and Shawshank and The Dark Knight Rises and Inception. And I'm like, that I don't know anything about you. You're just a guy now.
Have you heard, you know? Have you seen Pulp Fiction, buddy?
There was a guy waiting at AMC to get interviewed, and I was like, yeah, like, what's your deal? I was like, ask him what his favorite movie is. And he said, the Looney Tunes movie. And I was like, there's a story behind that. Now yeah, I want to know more about you. That's pretty yeah. fucking sick.
I think cool. it's not that you can't have similar favorite albums as everyone else, but like, just explain it, because there's so many people that are just like, oh, my favorite album ever is To Pimp a Butterfly, and then you'll be like, okay, why? And I'll be like, it's just so good,
dude. So many people gave it such high scores and won a bunch of Grammys.
Don't like, you know, like, it's the like, number one rated album on Radio Music.
But like that can be your favorite album, but tell me why. Why is
you're
it
more interesting,
why is it,
if you have an off?
Yeah, why is it personal to you is the thing that we need to get at. Anyway, yeah.
Here, Luke, I'll do the dinosaur effects, you do the soundtrack, okay? We'll pretend it's Jurassic Park, okay?
All right. I'm going to leave that way you don't see my mouth doing it. It's like it's like
gotcha.
No. Oh my god, no. No. No, don't do it.